The two-year anniversary of the deadly tornado outbreak in Kentucky and Indiana is this Sunday. It's a day survivors will always remember. WLKY's Lexi Sheen caught up with one man who recounted the frightening ordeal.
We first saw Tony Brock walking out of the Catholic Church in Henryville moments after the hailstorm that followed the tornado outbreak. His face and head were bleeding, he was carrying his dog, and was visibly shaken up. 2 years later, he's reliving those terrifying moments exclusively with us.
Things are starting to get rather tumultuous around here.
A very strong tornado on the ground.
Wind gusts estimated near 100 miles per hour
towards Henryville. A very, very dangerous situation, possibly a deadly situation unfolding.
All right, guys, so here's the deal. We just had a huge tornado come through. We're in Henryville, Indiana.
Moments after an EF4 tornado barreled through southern Indiana, this red truck was in the center of the destruction. Tony Brock was behind the wheel, dog Princess in tow.
There was just all kinds of debris flying in the air. I was in my truck, I hit my brakes, I covered my head and went down behind the dash, and it just rode it out. I thought it was never going to end.
Seconds felt like minutes. Tony opened his eyes to this destruction.
It's total chaos. It's unreal. It's unreal. It's like this place has been bombed or something. It's terrible.
It's been 2 years since that devastating day. For Tony and Princess, the physical scars have healed.
But it doesn't hit home until it actually happens to you. We're not guaranteed another day, and that day I thought was my day.
He was on his way to his in-laws' house for shelter.
I was heading south on 31, which put me right in front of the school, just past Budrow's bus stop.
He calls it Budrow's bus stop, the restaurant's new name, after a school bus crashed right through the front doors. Tony was just yards away, left bleeding from the truck's glass. 75 pieces still embedded in his head today.
I thought I was okay at the time, but I guess I was a little more dazed, maybe in shock. My hands, from my wrist to my knuckles, were just road rash. My hands hurt worse than anything else.
Princess only suffered a tiny cut. Now, slowly, Tony and his family have been moving on.
Compared to what other people went through, I'm fine, I'm great. I thought I was prepared, I just waited too long. The warnings were there, I should have left earlier.
He's using this opportunity, urging others to take the necessary precautions when it comes to the weather.
Be prepared, be aware, be ready, and don't wait.
Last year, there was a parade and a number of remembrance events in Henryville to bring the community together on the one-year anniversary. This time around, there's nothing officially planned, and only a handful of recovery projects are left to be completed. I'm Lexi Sheen, WLKY News.
Henryville was not the only place devastated by tornadoes. A ribbon cutting and dedication will be held tomorrow at noon at the newly restored Marysville Community Center.